But I'm like Caleb, coming into my promised land, a little bit older than the rest of them, but I'm saying, God, give me my mountain. I'm not going to give up. I'm not going to wait for something else to happen. I'm not going to live like the football players, you know, how they say somebody dropped a pass, a receiver, because he heard footsteps. Guys, you'll know what I'm talking about. He thinks somebody's going to hit him from the rear, so he doesn't catch the ball because he's expecting to be wounded or tackled from the rear. I lived nearly 10 years looking over my shoulder. I'm okay this year, but then here comes pneumonia again. I'm okay this year, but my energy level's up and down. I'm okay. I beat cancer, but I haven't gotten out of the woods yet. My mindset was, when is this Job-like trial going to be over? I needed to have that expectation, that hope, that everything was going to be solved by the working of the power of God. Think about it this way, the next slide. Our imagination is the gateway, and our meditation and our memory of things, I misspelled something on the slide, actually helps expand that expectation. So think about it this way. You may need to meditate on the Word of God. You may need to pray over the Word of God. You may need to even create rooms in your house where they're images of what you want to be. So I started getting all these muscle magazines. No, beneath this jacket is not Arnold Schwarzenegger's figure. I don't have that, but I'm in pretty good shape for a guy over 50. What I began to do was fill my mind with images of what I wanted, a hope beyond where I am today. God is going to use what you feed your spirit and expectation with. Does that make sense? Andrew Womack said it this way, if your life isn't going well, if things are a mess, it's because you've conceived it in your imagination. Now, I want to say no condemnation. That's kind of intense. But many times we just think in the norm. I'm believing for 20 more years of convergence phase of ministry. You and I need to come out of the grip of hopelessness. We need to come out of that place that says things aren't going to get better. Fear is to my faith and hope. It's like a cancer. The fears I allow to stay in my heart and life, eat away at my expectation. We're trying to have faith, but we're wondering, is it really going to work? I went through a season of time recently where I began to think after my wife passed, even though all this stuff is happening with me physically, I'm getting stronger and stronger. I began to wonder, am I too old too? Will I ever be in a place where I'll have that kind of relationship with my family that I had when my wife was here? Yeah. Will everything get back to some kind of new normal? Yeah. Can anybody relate to what I'm saying? Yeah. So I didn't realize that these were fears that were eating away, eating away, eating away, eating away, eating away at my faith. Eating away at my expectation, eating away at my confidence. But I believe that God wants us not to fear, not to be jealous, not to strive, but to seize our moment, not to worry about lack, but believe Him for resources, not to manipulate, but to align ourselves with God and His purpose in this generation. Our God is an awesome God, and He's desiring to breathe on your thinking today. Yeah.